you thought. Hey everybody, it's Ella Tai here, and we are back with another tutorial. This is my Bad and Bougie inspired look. So I decided to do my eyebrows off camera, and as you guys can see, I made sure to set the concealer with a translucent powder. And basically what I'm using the color Red Brick from MAC, and I'm using the E40 brush from Sigma, which is a really big fluffy blending brush to kind of create a nice base or transition shade. I'm now using the color Brown Script from MAC with the same eyeshadow brush. After that, I'm using the color Handwritten from MAC. And then to kind of deepen that color a little bit, I'm using this color from MAC called I'm Into It, which is like a burgundy purple shade. After that, I'm going in with this color from MAC called Shadowy Lady, and I'm kind of just like focusing that solely on the corners of my eyes with a small fluffy crease brush from Sigma. I don't know the name. I'm kind of bringing it up into my brow bone area to kind of create that more of a blown out look. After that, I'm gonna go in with this green eyeshadow. Honestly, you guys, I do not know what the name of this eyeshadow is, but any green eyeshadow will do. And I'm basically using a flat shader brush from Sigma to press that onto my eyeballs. After I do that, I'm going back in with a black eyeshadow. I'm using Carbon from MAC with that same crease brush that I used before. Now, to put a little bit more of a green tint to it, I'm using the Spellbinder shadow from MAC in the color Cosmic Clash. I really love it. So now what we're going to do is we are going to prime our face with the Nivea Post Shave Balm. I love this primer. I think it's great. It works for dry skin. It gives me really nice coverage. It makes sure that my foundation stays on all day, and it keeps my face hydrated. And I feel like if you have really dry skin, this is a great primer for you. So I'm kind of just waiting for it to get tacky a little bit. And after that, I'm going to use the Anastasia Beverly Hills foundation stick, but first I'm gonna hydrate my lips. So I'm just using a regular old chapstick because, you know, in New York it's so dry out here, so my lips have been getting really dry, so I'm trying to keep those hydrated and primed too. Now I'm gonna use the Anastasia Beverly Hills foundation stick in the color Ebony. I'm kind of just like, you know, drawing it all over my face, no particular pattern, just doing it, you know. I love this foundation. It's great. It's medium to full coverage. It is buildable. It is ideal for dry skin. So I use that. And I'm also using a really big, I don't know what the name of these brushes are called. It's a dupe of the artist brushes. I was sent these brushes from a company, and I really like using them to blend out my foundation. So I'm just blending out my foundation to the best of my ability, just to make sure that it is seamless and it is smooth all over my face. I think this really blends out my cream foundation pretty well. So now we're going to go back with a flat brush. I'm using the colors Chestnut and Fawn mixed together as my highlighter for my concealer. Now, to some, this may be a little bit too much. It may be a little bit too heavy. It may be a little bit too excessive. But the thing is, this is our Bad and Bougie inspired look. So the thing is, I feel like I have to really go really heavy-handed with the concealer. I always go heavy-handed with the concealer because I really enjoy highlighting and contouring. I love the process. I love the definition it gives my face. So I will always be heavy-handed with concealer. If you don't like this much concealer, then don't put this much on your face. So after we do that, we are going to take a damp beauty blender and we're going to dab that out to the best of our ability. As you guys can see, my makeup technique is pretty, consistent all across. Like, you know, I do the same technique, but I just like to create different looks. So I'm just kind of like making sure that it's really blended out and that there are no harsh lines and I don't really look like I'm wearing a mask. After that, we're going to go in with our black Radiance concealer stick in the color 8003. I really love this stick. If you're looking for a contour shade that is warm, I suggest stopping in at your local CVS, Walgreens, Rite Aid, or Target and looking for the little concealer stick that Black Radiance holds or carries. I'm just using a beauty blender to kind of blend out the harshness so it looks more airbrushed as opposed to just like blending it on my face. Now we're using the Black Opal setting powder in the color medium, and we're using that tapered brush from Sigma. I will never ever change that brush because I feel like it's really great when it comes to setting highlighted parts of the face. And of course, to some this may seem really yellow, but it's really not. It's more on the pinky orangey side. And now I'm gonna contour my face out. I'm setting my contour with Swiss chocolate from MAC, and I'm just using an angled contour brush to give me that definition. And honestly, like, you guys can see that I had I think I wiped the I didn't wipe the powder away. I'm gonna go back in with a pointed brush pretty soon and wipe the powder away. But I like to take I like to contour my face up, and after that, that's when I wipe the excess baking powder away, as you guys can see, just so I can remain highlighted in the areas that I want to remain highlighted in. So now what I'm doing is I'm kind of like using a small fluffy brush to set my nose contour. I'm using the color Brown Script from MAC. It is a great contour shade for my nose because it does not gray me out. After that, I think, what am I going to do after this? Ty, let them know what you're going to do after this. What are we doing after this? We are highlighting. Do you guys see this? Oh my god, I swear I love highlighting. Like, I used to, like, love blush, but I would rather be glowy and popping than blushed any day. So I'm using a fan brush. I'm using the Anastasia Sun Dip Kit, and I'm using the color Bronze. And then on top of that, I'm using the Beauty Bakery, the So Icy Illuminator, the gold one. I don't really know. They don't have a name for them. And I'm basically putting it on the tip of my nose, the bridge of my nose, to kind of create the illusion of a more structured and chiseled nose. After that, I'm going to take this liquid lipstick from the Beauty Bakery. It is Midnight Truffle. It is a black liquid lip. But I like to use this liquid lip as a base for when I mix other shades, because I like really deep, vampy lip colors. So as you guys can see, when I finish applying this liquid lipstick as a liner, the color I'm going to use to fill it in is going to be so outside of my comfort zone. But I love taking this green look and really, like, you know, making it my own. So I'm just going to line my lips and kind of press them together. And I'm taking this bright green lipstick from La Maxed. The color is called Zara. And I mixed it with the black liquid lipstick. And you guys see how it turns into this amazing forest green color. You guys see that right there? That is a nice little mix, okay? All right. Now we're going to go fix this hair. So I'm just going to brush it through really quickly. And I think since it's a Bad and Bougie inspired look, I want to do something that's really cute. A little different over the top, because the blonde hair is definitely different for me, and I love being blonde, so I try to play with it as much as I possibly can. So after I brush it out, I kind of put it half up, half down, but I feel like we were missing something. The hair needed some body, some life, something. So what I decided to do was I decided to kind of go and curl my hair up, and look at it now. Look how cute that is. So I kind of just, like, you know, put a couple of loose curls here and there to give it some body and structure and shape. It's not really supposed to be, like, you know, I'm not trying to style it anyway, but I just wanted it to have some type of loose wave to it. But now, you guys, we kind of need some lashes. We're kind of looking a little popping, but not really. So it's about time for us to glow up one time for the one time. So I'm going to go get some lashes and change my shirt, because I think you guys deserve to see the entire look put together. So I will be right back. And there we are, you guys. Oh my god, look at that. That is, I even brought the fur out. I even brought the fur. Look at the fur. Okay. I hope you guys enjoyed this look. I had such a great time filming it for you guys. It was completely out of my comfort zone, but I wanted to let my brown girls know that you can do anything. You can be blonde with green lips and looks and still look bomb. And you guys see this right here? Oh my god, hello. I came to slay for 2017. I came to slay. But comment, rate, subscribe, tell your friends to subscribe. Thank you guys so much for watching. Stay beautiful and goodbye, you guys.